naman ngayon yung ano, pinakamahal na kung may pera sila, iwasan na muna nila because they won't get a lot of upside from it naman.
Dito, nandito tayo ngayon okay. Sa BGC. It's very expensive here. So if you wanna buy in BGC, I suggest instead of buying pre-selling, try to buy resale property na medyo cheap yung selling price niya dahil ito yung mga owners na una sila sa BGC and they've earned a lot already. So hindi naman nila kailangan maximum yung price yung pagbebentahan nila okay. Pero more as long as they earn 20%.
Hi guys, walking vlog with Richard Carvalho. Okay, Richard, if I will invest today, can you give me areas dito in Metro Manila where hindi pa ganun kamahal na meron pa akong possible upside?
Number one is Mandaluyong and okay. Ortigas. Pag napadaan pala kayo ng Rockwell, you can check out the bridge. Malapit na mag-connect ang BGC at ang Ortigas, which cuts down the travel time to 10 minutes.
Okay, when you say Mandaluyong, you're talking about the Boni Pioneer area to...
Other side, Pioneer area, okay. Greenfield area, okay. Capitolio, okay. Ayun, Mandaluyong Ortigas area, Mandaluyong Pasig area. Okay. So yan yung mga yun. Also Quezon City, alam na ba nila na magkakasoler sa Quezon City?
Ah, near Trinoma?
Yes, okay, sa may Vertis North.
The Trinoma area, is it still cheap there? I've seen prices in Quezon City go up.
Actually, only Ayala properties ang expensive sa Quezon okay. City. Pero other developers are actually cheap okay. sa Quezon City. Like for example, SMDC, okay. like, may mga properties sila like Glam Residences. So yun, mababa pa yung monthly amortization. And there's really big potential for growth. Okay. Anywhere na malapit sa bridge okay. or may access sa bridge na magkoconnect sa okay. BGC.
When you're saying, mura tong area to, what should I do? I buy it, then hold it, then sell it later on, or rental?
Pwedeng both eh. Pero mas maganda if you buy it, hold it, and sell it later on. Kasi mamamaximize mo yung capital appreciation. Meron nagbenta sa akin ng property. Okay. 12 million na yung market value. Dun sa mismong malapit sa bridge na yun, nakuha ko lang siya ng 6.5 million pesos.
Ano to? Condo?
I'm waiting for it to be flipped out, 3-bedroom.
So, for those that will buy today, ilan years nila i-hold para sulit yung possible yield na makukuha nila?
Within 5 years, okay na. Five. You can exit within 5 years. Pero okay rin if paparent nila yung area na yun. Talagang developing, growing yung area na yun.
Saan naman ngayon yung ano, pinakamahal na kung may pera sila, iwasan na muna nila because they won't get a lot of upside from it naman.
Dito, nandito tayo ngayon okay. sa BGC. It's very expensive here. So if you wanna buy in BGC, I suggest instead of buying pre-selling, try to buy resale property na medyo cheap yung selling price niya dahil ito yung mga owners na una sila sa BGC and they've earned a lot already. So hindi naman nila kailangan maximum yung price yung pagbebentahan nila. Okay. Pero more as long as they earn 20%.
Price range in BGC, 1 bedroom, 50 square meter, how much would it be?
The best you'll get is 200,000 per square meter in okay. BGC. Highest, it can go as much as 375,000 okay. per square meter.
Moa area, mura mahal.
Mahal per okay. square meter. If you compute per square meter, nasa 300,000 per square meter din.
So, should they go for that then or iwas muna doon kasi medyo mahal na?
Maraming nagbebenta ng cheaper property doon na pasalo. Oh. So, if you can buy a property doon na around 200,000 per square meter, grab it.
Makati, mura mahal?
Depende sa area eh. Medyo okay. ano eh, merong farther side na Makati like Pasong Tamo.
Okay.
And ano, so okay pa doon. And then mga Salcedo, Legazpi, medyo expensive na din siya.
Okay.
Pero actually, Makati would still give you a very good yield.
Okay.
Ibig sabihin, mataas yung renta nila despite okay. having high amount of property, which makes the investment good.
So how about Poblacion?
Ayan, sobrang mahal din ang property sa Poblacion. Pero Poblacion is more of commercial okay. properties.
How about Nuvali area, Bulacan area, Clark? Mura mahal?
It's not Clark, pero outside Clark, yung surrounding areas ng Clark. Nuvali, medyo expensive na siya. If you go farther, yung bandang Cavite na dinedevelop nila, cheaper siya, mas okay siya.
A lot of people are asking this, Roland, outside Metro Manila, pero hindi nila mababaten. Should you recommend that to people?
Roland is good if pinamana lang sa inyo. Usually, the market for Roland is either yung solar windmills or telco site for new telco, third telco. They're looking for a lot of lands na tinatayuan ng satellite. And then they're renting this out from the people.
Just to recap everything, the cheaper areas are Pasig, Mandaluyong area. Greenfield. Then you also have Greenfield. Then you also have yung sa Quezon City na area as well. You can put that. The more expensive areas in Quezon City are the Ayala areas. Then the more expensive ones, BGC, MOA, And of course, Makati, you have to be very, very selective. So these are all rules of thumb. The whole technique here is you just have to find kung ano yung pwede mong habilin that will actually make sense for you. Kasi that's how it works, no? You don't just get the rule of thumb, you just don't get the sector. It will always go back to the price that you can actually buy it as well. Mas mahal sa BGC, mas mahal sa Makati, mas mahal sa MOA area, mas mura sa Pioneer, Mandaluyong, mas mura sa Quezon City. Pero will it also give that much upside kahit mas mura siya?
It's possible kasi there is potential growth, eh, okay, which is the most important thing when you're looking for property. Though it might not go as high as this area, there is a strong potential for ano talaga, rental yield, kasi nga mababa mo nakuha. Remember, the concept is if lower mo nakuha yung price ng property, higher yung yield, okay, na makukuha mo. And of course, there is a market talaga. A lot of companies, like from Puare, BDO, dati Makati sila, and then now yung head office nila nasa Ortigas na.
Okay.
So a lot of companies are also moving in that area. At saka pa-north yung mga properties. Okay, look out for cheap property, for good deals, huwag nyo papakawalan. You just have to constantly look. Malay nyo may matiming kayong good buy property.
So I guess that's it for now. He's gonna go to his car already. This is a very, very quick walking vlog. Inabuso ko lang talaga si Richard habang nandito. I hope this video helps you trade well, trade strong, trade smart. And I hope that based on all of this, it gives you enough information for you to be able to invest. Kasi sayang eh, we are in one of the best and greatest opportunities to make money and invest. And I hope that you actually start and execute as well. So bye everyone.
Bye-bye.